opening statement, second home game and the first since early December. What were your thoughts?
Felt good to be back home when you can play like that. Especially against a team that we just played, a few days ago, and to turn it around and make it a pretty big difference. So it's great to be home. It's great to get a win.
What was one thing that stood out to you after last week's game against Newberry coming in today? We know the energy was, we could feel it in the arena, but what was one thing in terms of the game plan that you focused on for this one?
Well, we really talked about that the game plan doesn't work if you don't work. It doesn't really make any difference how we say we're going to play a ball screen or how we're going to defend a cross screen or a down screen or whatever that is. If you're not playing with the intention of stopping them, it doesn't make any difference what the game plan is. And I think that they really took that to heart of that. We talked about what the final measure of the game is, and most people look at it as the final score, but that there is a competition every second that they're out there for space, for position, for the ball, and that in the first Newberry game, we felt like Newberry won the battle for space. They won the offensive rebounding battle, and I felt like we did a better job of winning all of those many competitions that ended up affecting the big one that everybody can see.
Outside of Jay Wilson, and we saw Hancock also produce in double figures, but who are some other names? Because 13 of the 16 student athletes that played in this game scored. So who are some names that impressed you in this game?
Haley Hatfield is just a workhorse. She did not have a particularly great offensive game, but I think she ended up with 14 rebounds. And she doesn't do that by out-jumping people. She wins her battle by positioning and anticipating and just really getting in there and pushing and shoving. And I thought some people that came off the bench did a good job of staying engaged and focused, because it's easy for them to – if you sit over there for a while, then you're kind of like, oh, well, am I going to get to go in or I'm not going to get to go in? But I thought that the people came off the bench were ready to go when they got their opportunity.
You all had so much success in the paint. What do you feel like was different in this one in terms of just looks on offense or just overall confidence?
It's nice. The ball went in the basket for us early. And they got up like 14, I don't remember exactly how many. And I think that just makes everybody feels better when you get a couple of baskets and then you can start rolling. And they didn't shoot the ball particularly well. And so we just sort of built off of that. I think Eileen got a basket, kind of early. Hannah did a better job of finishing around the basket and getting in there and making some things happen. But I thought we had probably maybe two of the best plays that we've had all year where – Hannah made a nice drive to the basket and she kicked it out to Jaya in the corner in the first half and she made that three. And then a couple of plays later, somebody kicked it out to Jaya and she made one more to Lauren Sullivan that made a three right in front of their bench. And I think that those were very unselfish plays and, we gave up a good shot for a better shot. And that's, I'm not sure, 13 assists may be our best for the season. We were still one short of being, positive or even, but 13 assists is a good number for us.
What did you tell the team in the locker room after this game?
That we should do that every time. But I talked about the same thing that I told you about. I felt like we won the competition for the space and the positioning and the loose balls and the offensive glass. That I thought that they did that ended up being the difference in the scoreboard, and they took that, seriously.
Your team hasn't had a lot of time off recently, just practices and stuff. What's the game plan as you have to quickly turn around and play a Coker team on Wednesday?
Well, this is kind of awesome because this is like professional basketball, because it's just play basketball and get ready for the next game. We did talk about, getting a lot of rest, hydrating, make sure you're getting your treatment and that kind of stuff. But this one will be a little bit different because we usually have 2 days to prepare. So tomorrow will be some film work. We'll try to learn from the things that we need to get better in this one, watch some Coker and kind of walk through their stuff and sort of, maybe take a lighter practice approach.
Well, so that one practice before the Coker game, like you said, that's kind of unique, right, to just have to pr- practice once and then play. So, like, what do you try and do as a coach when you are dealt this type of situation to make sure that your team is prepared given the short notice?
Well, all of my stuff is already ready for Coker. I've already watched all their games. And they'll be very different than Newberry. Coker plays almost every possession 2-2-1, three-quarter court press back into like a 3-2 zone. They do play some man, and they can mix it up. They can play some 2-3, but the majority of the time is 2-2-1 back into 3-2 every time, and we haven't seen a lot of that. So we'll try to show it to them on video and then give them a chance to, you know, sort of walk through and show them maybe where some things would be open and then kind of go through the plays that they run the most. So that's, you know, when you have a young team or a team that doesn't have as much experience, it's kind of roll the dice and here we go. But if they will play their principles, and we're talking about it's not always the game plan. It is, if you play really hard, it doesn't make that much difference what the other team is doing. It's nice to know and kind of have a head start, but you got to outwork them every time.
Thanks for your time, Coach.
Okay, thank you.